Sunshine on my shoulders makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me cry.
And sunshine on our roofs can light our darkness even when the sun is resting on the other side of the earth. It seems we get phone calls almost every day offering to put solar panels on top of our homes. The old-timers on the coast side will tell you, we don't have as much fog as in the old days, but still, it can get pretty gloomy in the winter when we need more electricity to heat our homes and warm the clam chowder. My guest today is Rafael Reyes, Director of Energy Programs for Peninsula Clean Energy. Welcome, Rafael.
Oh, thank you, Bill. It's a pleasure to be here.
Well, our electric bill, we see a line for PG&E, which makes sense, but there's another line that shows a charge for Peninsula Clean Energy. Tell us who that is.
Sure. So Peninsula Clean Energy is San Mateo County's not-for-profit electricity service provider. We were established in 2016 to provide cleaner power at lower rates for the county and make investments to advance clean energy.
Of course, there is a website which would give us all kinds of information. What's that number?
That is peninsulacleanenergy.com, all one word.
I did look at the website. There's a lot of information on there.
Well, we have not only provide cleaner power to the residents and businesses in the county, and we do that saving people substantial amounts of money, over $18 million a year through that electricity service. But we also have a range of programs for residents and businesses for electric vehicle charging, solar power, and other ways to lower our impacts on climate change.
Now, you have a goal of providing 100% renewable energy by 2025. But until then, where's the electricity coming from now?
Right now, Peninsula Clean Energy has two products for people. One is Eco 100, which is 100% renewable today. Anybody can sign on. And it's about a penny more per kilowatt hour for that service. But most of our customers are on our Eco Plus product, which is 100%, nearly 100% greenhouse gas free, but has a different mix of power. And that includes quite a bit of hydropower. About half of that is hydropower. And about the other half are other renewable sources like solar, wind, etc.
So when 2025 comes along, what will be the actual mix of renewable energy?
So the actual mix that we're targeting will be mostly solar, a heavy portion of wind, but then some other smaller renewable sources like geothermal.
Geothermal. And where would that be located? That's interesting.
Well, California has quite a bit of geothermal power. Most of that is in the Sierras, and there are a number of sources there that we procure from and will be in the future.
San Mateo residents that this serves, do they have to sign up for Peninsula Clean Energy?
Peninsula Clean Energy was established in 2016, and all of residents and businesses were by default opted in. They had the option to opt out to stay solely with PG&E service. And I should take a moment to explain how this works, because it is a little bit confusing. We provide the electricity generation service, so it's half of that service, and PG&E provides the distribution services. So in other words, PG&E still owns and operates the wires that the electricity is distributed on. Residents do not have to explicitly sign up for Peninsula Clean Energy to get those benefits.
So it's just there, it's all put together on the bill. First you look at a bill and you're going, what's that? Okay, now we know. You're giving us the electricity. PG&E sees that it gets to us.
That's right.
I believe you also have a program for electric vehicles.
Yes, we have a range of programs. One of them is for electric vehicles, so we offer rebates up to $4,000 specifically for used electric vehicles, because we know now that most purchases of vehicles is in the used car market. And particularly for lower income people, this is an important way for them to get access to those vehicles and save a lot of money doing that.
Now, when we talk of renewable energy, our first thought usually is solar panels on our top of our homes. Now, how much does residential solar actually contribute to the renewable energy amount today?
Solar power on homes is incredibly important in a lot of ways. first of all, historically, right, that was the only way to get renewable energy. There was such a small percentage on the grid. Now, fortunately, there's much more renewable on the grid, but it's still incredibly important to add more solar. Number two, to lower utility bills because you get those savings. And also, it can add resilience. So if you add battery system to your solar panels, then you get that resilience in the case of a power outage.
And of course, we get calls every day, it seems. Somebody wants to put solar panels on our roof. How do we know we're going to get the right people, the right price, and will it end up working? I mean, are there people out there that we shouldn't really be talking to?
Yeah, it's a great question. You know, it's a market. So buyer beware is always really important when dealing with the market. In general, we advise people to get multiple bids. First of all, look at references and other sources like the Better Business Bureau and things like that. In general, larger companies are more likely to deliver better quality. We have partnered with Sunrun. They're a large and well-established solar company that provides these services. You need to be selective and think about who you're partnering with.
There is a program that's actually aimed at the coast side. Tell us about that.
We have had two significant programs that have been important for the coast side on solar. First of all, we know that power outages have been a big challenge, and we had a program to offer free batteries to people with medical devices where they were dependent on that electricity service for their medical devices. And we delivered over 250 battery systems, some also with solar power. That's been an important service, I think, to the community. And then secondly, as I mentioned, we have a partnership with Sunrun and are currently offering $500 incentives as part of that service. And it not only provides for solar power with batteries, but also provides some power to the grid when the grid needs it.
And who would people call?
They can go to our website, peninsulacleanenergy.com, and under looking at the residential programs, you can find a solar program there, and that will direct to the point of contact for this program.
Now, this one kind of hits close to home because I thought, okay, I should look into solar. It only makes sense. I was a little suspicious as to whether we were going to be able to do it because of the way our roof was laid out. So when the guy showed up, I could already see he was kind of thinking, we have gables on the back of our house where the sun is. So when he looked at that, he goes, okay, well, you're going to splatter some panels over here. Then we'll have to go to the front of the house and put some on the side of the garage. Okay, well, and then the kicker was we had to put the inverter outside, and it would end up being basically about 6 feet from our front door, and then the landscaping would have to be cleared away. And by then, he had given up. So now, what are our options? It's obvious, at least at this point in time, it's not practical for us. Is there something else we can do to contribute to saving energy or save our electric bill?
There are many things that customers can do, and you're right. Some homes, the way the home is put together, can make it difficult to do certain kinds of projects. The options that customers have for saving on their bills, for example, include energy efficiency projects. There's a regional program called BayREN where you can get rebates, including some from Peninsula Clean Energy, where we also collaborate with them for rebates. If you're really looking at bill savings, frankly, the most important thing you can do is get an electric vehicle. You can save a lot of money with an electric vehicle. It's much less expensive. We're saving, and we calculated for ourselves, $150 a month on lower cost for driving that electric vehicle than a gas car. So that would be number one. And then there are other options in terms of electrifying the home to reduce carbon and environmental impacts.
And, of course, that old furnace, which is in there, inefficient. I know where I live, there were a number of homes all built in the 70s. These are furnaces that should be in the museum. Somebody would say, well, you know, I don't want a new furnace. And I said, you know, it's going to pay for itself real quick because these old things, you might as well be shoveling coal in them. They're just don't have the efficiency.
Absolutely. And, you know, people are concerned about, in some cases, air conditioning. It hasn't been something that people have used much now. But if you're thinking about replacing a furnace and you're thinking that you want to get an air conditioner, the best thing you can do is get a heat pump, because a heat pump can do both space heating and cooling, and it's incredibly efficient.
Well, we've covered a lot of information in a short period of time. And again, there's a website where you can explore it in more detail and get the context you need.
Yes, and that's peninsulacleanenergy.com, all one word. Find us there and a ton of great programs for people to participate in.
Rafael, I want to thank you for joining us today, helping us look into the future of electricity in our home.
Great. Thank you very much, Bill.
Many ancient cultures worshipped the sun. It made perfect sense. The golden disk brought light, warmth, crops, and it was free. In spite of the fact that Mr. Sun has lost his status as a god, he still has gifts to offer. This is Bill Wood for the Radio Magazine.